Hello and welcome to In Depth. I'm Tina Jha. On the show today, we talk about a dangerous and deadly fungal infection, Candida auris. The fungus is emerging as a global threat, having spread in at least 15 countries and claimed several hundred lives. Identified in 2009 in Japan, the deadly fungus is now infecting patients in hospitals and nursing homes around the world. According to the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, nearly half of the patients who contract Candida auris die within 90 days. Yet, scientists haven't been able to nail down where the fungus came from in the first place. But why is the fungus so dangerous? Which are the countries in which it is spreading? And who are at risk? Let's find out today in depth. Candida auris is a mysterious and dangerous fungal infection that is reportedly spreading rapidly. If it gets into the bloodstream, the fungus can cause life-threatening infections. What is the fungal infection and how is it posing a threat to the world? Let's understand in this report.
The fungal infection Candida auris has spread all over the world, raising alarm in the medical community. It has been responsible for a number of deaths around the globe. What's alarming is that the fungus remains active and continues to multiply even after it has killed someone. Last year in May, an elderly man was admitted to Brooklyn's Mount Sinai Hospital for abdominal surgery and blood tests revealed he was infected with a mysterious germ. He was quickly confined to an intensive care unit. 90 days later, he died. But the fungus, Candida auris, which was present in his body, did not. Tests showed it was everywhere in his room. Special cleaning equipment had to be used and some of the ceiling and floor tiles had to be ripped out to eradicate the fungus. According to a report in the New York Times, the walls, the bed, the doors, the curtains, the phones, the sink, the whiteboard, the poles, the pump, everything in the hospital room where the elderly man died tested positive of Candida auris. According to the Center for Disease Control and Prevention, there have been 587 Candida auris cases reported in the United States, most of them in New York, New Jersey, and Illinois. The fungus has now spread through at least 15 countries with deadly consequences. Over the last 5 years, it has hit a neonatal unit in Venezuela, swept through a hospital in Spain, forced a prestigious British medical center to shut down its intensive care unit, and taken root in India, Pakistan, and South Africa. According to a Forbes report, Candida auris can remain on people's skin and objects like hospital furniture and equipment for a long time. It can even spread indirectly from patient to patient. It can invade the human body and kill if the immune system is weakened. It can be resistant to the three major classes of antifungal drugs, leaving doctors with few options to treat Candida auris infections.
See, this Candida auris is a fungal infection. To be more precise, it is a yeast infection. It is an emerging disease which was first discovered in 2009, and since then several cases have been reported in America and several other countries. And why are people alarmed about it? People are alarmed about it because some of it is a little drug resistant. It is hard to treat this disease and it gallops as an infection. But only people who have a compromised immune system are vulnerable to this.
Candida auris preys on people with weakened immune systems. These include the elderly, those who are already sick, newborn babies, and pregnant women. People with weakened immunity are likely to have more trouble fighting off an initial invasion by Candida auris. Places like hospitals and nursing homes are where the infection is more prevalent. Due to its resistance to major antifungal drugs, C. auris has been dubbed a global emerging threat by the Center for Disease Control and Prevention in the United States. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
So Candida auris is an emerging infection that causes healthcare-associated infections. It can be misidentified by laboratories and is considered to be particularly problematic because it is resistant to antifungal drugs currently available. Our next report examines the symptoms of the disease, which is spreading rapidly across countries.
The Candida auris fungus attacks patients with a weakened immune system. It was first discovered in 2009 in Japan, but an analysis of the fungus revealed it was already identified in 1996 in South Korea. In the past 5 years, the fungus has been identified in India, Pakistan, South Africa, Venezuela, and Spain. Recently, the Candida auris fungus reached New York, New Jersey, and Illinois, leading the US government to add it to a list of germs deemed urgent threats.
There were some 500 cases in America which are reported by the Centers for Disease Control, which is the largest cohort I have seen. The first case came from Japan, but the largest case numbers are reportedly from America. Some of the case numbers from India are still not available or not in public domain with me. But then some cases have been reported, and it's not surprising. We are a population of 1.3 billion Candidiasis infections are fairly common in the country because we are a tropical country and there's lots of these fungal infections, and fungal infections are also hard to treat.
Symptoms of Candida auris infection depend on the part of the body that is affected. It can cause many different types of infections such as bloodstream infection, wound infection, and ear infection. A person infected with this life-threatening fungus experiences symptoms like fever, sepsis, aches, and fatigue. The symptoms may not be noticeable because patients with the infection are often already sick with another illness or condition. Candida auris mainly affects patients who already have many medical problems and often affects people who have had frequent hospital stays or live in nursing homes. It is more likely to affect patients who suffer from conditions such as blood cancer or diabetes, receive lots of antibiotics, or have devices like tubes going into their body. Healthy people are less likely to get Candida auris infections. The biggest concern is that this fungus is multi-drug resistant. The infection can be serious and even fatal, as there is no treatment available for the infection yet.
Well, there are certain drugs which can help with it, but most of the drugs are not able to attack this infection. That is what the reports from CDC suggest. But then people can get cured from this. But since it's a very new infection, no specific drugs are available which will help in the cure of this.
While some species of fungi are naturally resistant to treatment with certain types of antifungal medications, other species can develop resistance over time due to improper antifungal use. This means that the infection is not killed and continues to grow. Candida auris belongs to the second category and is continuing to spread in hospitals around the world. Some types of Candida auris fungi are increasingly resistant to the first line and second line antifungal medications. It can remain on people's skin and objects such as hospital furniture and equipment for quite a long time. It can also spread indirectly from patient to patient. For decades, public health experts have warned that the overuse of antibiotics was reducing the effectiveness of drugs that have lengthened lifespans by curing bacterial infections once commonly fatal. But lately, there has been an explosion of resistant fungi as well. Candida auris is a new addition in the list of emerging infectious diseases.
But antimicrobial resistance is a serious problem which only you and I can control. If we have antibiotics in the dosage which our physicians recommend, antimicrobial resistance will not happen. So if you properly take the full course of the antibiotic, these bugs don't become resistant to antibiotics.
Its emergence is a reminder that other microbes present can also become resistant to available drugs, leading to a possible global health crisis. With inputs from Aastha Kulshreshth, Bureau Report for Rajya Sabha TV.
Time for a short break on the program. On the other side, we'll talk about the preventive measures against Candida virus. Do stay with us.
Begin our journey from the land of rising sun, the largest state in the northeastern region of India, that is Arunachal Pradesh.
कितने सालों से दिख रहा है अरुणाचल की इधर स्थिर हम लोग का जो कैपिटल रोड है वो अब तक डेवलप नहीं है और ये मैं करप्शन के बारे में पूछना चाहती हूँ आप भ्रष्टाचार कैसे हटाएंगे सबसे पहले कहाँ से शुरू करेंगे
आप लोग जो अरुणाचल का जो लीडर लोग है आप लोग नहीं बोल के एक्शन में कब आएगा ये मेरा सवाल है
इन ऑर्डर टू मेक अरुणाचल करप्शन फ्री स्टेट यू शुड टेक प्लेस टुडे राइट नाउ
दिस इज नाउ पॉलिटिकल पार्टी पीपीए हैज मेड अ सिंगल पॉइंट ऑफ स्लोगन करप्शन हटाओ अरुणाचल बचाओ
बीजेपी का पहला मुद्दा है जब तक बीजेपी सरकार है कभी भी पीआरसी नहीं आएगा दैट्स फाइनल
करंट पॉलिटिकल सिचुएशन इज टॉपसी-टर्वी पॉलिटिकल सिचुएशन ऑन अरुणाचल
We have to take up serious issues pertaining to the people of the state and the country as a whole.
Watch The Big Picture with me, Vishal Dahiya, at 6:30 p.m. on Rajya Sabha TV.
Shahjahan wanted a place where he can design a new city and a new palace of his own choice.
Shahjahan's architecture, you've achieved a classical type style, an emphasis on symmetry, on balance, on not over ornamentation. Probably the most remarkable part of the Red Fort, to my mind, and it's still extant, is the throne in the public audience hall.
India united for the first time, seen from the Red Fort in 1857, the second time during the INA trials, that is 1945-46, and then again in 1947.
पोस्टल बैलेट से वोटिंग कुछ खास वोटरों के लिए ही है इनमें सरकारी अधिकारी सैन्य बल सशस्त्र पुलिस बल चुनाव की ड्यूटी के लिए अपने राज्य से बाहर तैनात अधिकारी उनकी पत्नी या देश से बाहर कार्यरत सरकारी अधिकारी आते हैं इस प्रक्रिया में चुनाव आयोग पहले ही किसी चुनाव क्षेत्र में पोस्टल बैलेट करने वालों की संख्या को निर्धारित कर लेता है इसके बाद खाली पोस्टल बैलेट को इलेक्ट्रॉनिक तरीके से वोटर तक पहुंचाया जाता है अगर वोटर ऐसी जगह है जहां इलेक्ट्रॉनिक तरीके का इस्तेमाल नहीं किया जा सकता तो वहां डाक सेवा से इसे भेजा जाता है उस मतपत्र को मतदाता पूरी तरीके से भरकर गैजेटेड अधिकारी से वेरिफाई कराकर इस फॉर्म को वापस पोस्ट करता है
नेता बेशक राजनीति करें लेकिन जनता का तो असली मतलब होता है अर्थनीति से यानी वो नीतियाँ जो हमारी जेब पर असर डालें या फिर सुविधाओं में इजाफा करें कैसा है भारत का आर्थिक वातावरण और क्या है हमारी चुनौतियाँ। सरल भाषा में आपके ये बुनियादी आर्थिक मुद्दे आप तक पहुँचाने के लिए राज्यसभा टीवी ने शुरू किया है ये खास कार्यक्रम अर्थनीति।
देखिए विशेष मेरे साथ आज शाम 7:30 बजे सिर्फ राज्यसभा टीवी पर।
ईवीएम यानी इलेक्ट्रॉनिक वोटिंग मशीन। इस मशीन में दो यूनिट होती हैं, एक मतदान अधिकारी के पास और दूसरी कंपार्टमेंट के अंदर जहां से आप मतदान करते हैं। ईवीएम को चलाने के लिए बिजली की जरूरत नहीं होती क्योंकि ये चलती है बैटरी से। एक ईवीएम मशीन में अधिकतर 3,840 वोट दर्ज हो सकते हैं, लेकिन अमूमन किसी एक मतदान केंद्र पर लगभग 1500 मतदाता ही वोट डालते हैं। हर ईवीएम में 16 उम्मीदवार के नाम जोड़े जा सकते हैं। अगर उम्मीदवार ज्यादा हों तो और मशीनों को जोड़ा जाता है। इस तरह 4 मशीनों तक को जोड़ा जा सकता है। ईवीएम की खास बात यह है कि इससे बूथ कैप्चरिंग काफी मुश्किल है क्योंकि मशीन में 1 मिनट में सिर्फ 5 वोट ही डाले जा सकते हैं।
According to healthcare agencies, almost half of the patients who contract Candida auris die within 90 days, but the fungus continues to thrive. Although finding a cure is a matter of urgency for this deadly disease, there are steps that healthcare facilities are taking to control the spread of Candida auris.
Candida auris is a fungus that causes serious infections. C. auris can spread from one patient to another in healthcare settings such as hospitals and nursing homes. Patients with C. auris infection, their family members and other close contacts, public health officials, laboratory staff and healthcare personnel can all help stop it from spreading. To begin with, detecting and diagnosing this fungus quickly are important. However, this is not always easy, since C. auris can be mistaken for other types of Candida species. Though special precautions reduce the chance of spreading the fungus to other patients, these precautions include: once a patient is diagnosed with having C. auris, the healthcare facility should place the patient in a separate room as soon as possible. Everyone entering the room should take precautions that include wearing disposable gloves and gowns. Clean your hands with hand sanitizer or soap and water before and after touching a patient with C. auris or equipment in his or her room. Wounds should be bandaged to prevent any fluids from seeping out and infecting others. It is also key for healthcare facilities with C. auris to regularly and thoroughly clean and disinfect affected patients' rooms with special cleaners known to work against fungi.
For this particular disease, Candida auris, as the Centers for Disease Control says, it's very hard to figure out the symptoms because it happens mostly alongside with other disease symptoms. So it's very hard to figure out whether you have this, but mostly it happens to people who have had long stays in hospital.
Several agencies working for disease preventions work with public health partners, healthcare personnel and laboratories to stop the spread of C. auris in healthcare settings. Agencies recommend laboratory staff and healthcare personnel to report cases quickly to public health departments. Investigate C. auris cases quickly and determine additional ways to prevent spread. Clean patient rooms thoroughly with a disinfectant that works against C. auris. Conduct surveillance for new cases to detect ongoing transmission. It also advises precautions for as long as the person is affected with C. auris. Periodic reassessments for presence of C. auris colonization, example every 3 months for a patient with known C. auris colonization, could help inform duration of infection control measures.
Well, it is a communicable disease, it's an infection. Certainly it is, but there are certain drugs and regimens which you can take, which only physicians can prescribe and specialized physicians can prescribe, which will help in the cure of this. But by and large, I don't think people should worry that tomorrow you go on the street and you will get candida auris. That will not happen.
Healthcare agencies have also recommended that C. auris can persist on surfaces in healthcare environments. It added C. auris has been cultured from multiple locations in patient rooms, including both high-touch surfaces such as bedside tables and bed rails, and locations further away from the patients such as windowsills. C. auris has also been identified on mobile equipment such as glucometers, temperature probes, blood pressure cuffs, ultrasound machines and nursing carts. Meticulous cleaning and disinfection of both patient rooms and mobile equipment is necessary to reduce the risk of transmission. People who have tested positive for C. auris should inform healthcare providers that they have tested positive for C. auris when visiting healthcare offices and when being admitted to hospitals and nursing homes. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
Fungal infections are common throughout much of the natural world. In humans, fungal infections occur when an invading fungus takes over an area of the body and is too much for the immune system to handle. Fungi can live in the air, soil, water, as well as plants. There are also some fungi that live naturally in the human body. In our next report, let's talk about some fungal infections that affect the human body.
Fungal diseases are caused by a variety of fungi commonly found in the environment. Invasive infections rarely occur in healthy people, but individuals with weakened immune systems are vulnerable. Fungi live outdoors in soil, plants and trees, and even indoor surfaces and human skin. There are millions of different species of fungi, but only a fraction make people sick. Mild fungal skin diseases can look like a rash and are very common. Fungal diseases in the lungs are often similar to illness like flu or tuberculosis. Some like fungal meningitis and bloodstream infections are less common but very deadly. Common fungal symptoms include skin changes, including red and possibly cracking or peeling skin, itching. Fungal skin infections are common and include athlete's foot, jock itch, ringworm and yeast infections. Athlete's foot is a common fungal infection that affects the foot. It's associated with sports and athletes because the fungus grows perfectly in warm, moist environment like socks and shoes, sports equipment and locker rooms. It is most common in warmer climates and summer months where it can quickly multiply, include redness or blisters. The infected skin may be soft or layers may peel or crack with itching, stinking and burning. Athlete's foot is often treated with topical antifungal ointments. Severe infections can require oral medications. Feet will need treatment and kept dry to kill the fungus. Jock itch is a common infection that is caused by a fungus called Tinea. The fungus thrives in warm, moist areas of the body, which mean it can affect the genitals, inner thighs and buttocks. Infections occur more frequently in summer or in warm, wet climates. Jock itch appears as a ring-shaped red itchy rash. It is only mildly contagious. Symptoms include itching, chafing or burning in the groin or thighs, redness in the groin or thigh, flaking, peeling or cracking skin. Treatment involves keeping affected area clean and dry and applying topical antifungal medications. Ringworm is caused by fungus that lives on dead tissues like skin, hair and nails. It causes jock itch and athlete's foot. A red patch that may itch or be scaly will often turn into a raised, ring-shaped patch of skin over time. It may even spread out into several rings. Ringworm is highly contagious and can be transmitted by skin-to-skin contact or contact with pets. Creams and medicated ointments are often enough to treat it. Basic hygiene can prevent ringworm. Yeast infections are caused by yeast-like fungi called Candida. They occur when yeast on the skin causes a red, scaling, itchy rash. Yeast infections are not contagious. They may affect any skin surface on the body, but are most likely to occur in warm, moist, creased areas, including armpits and the groin. Candida infection is especially common among people who are obese or diabetic. It can cause diaper rash in infants or infections of the nail. Oral thrush is found in the mouth. Signs of yeast infection include rash, patches that ooze clear fluid, pimple-like bumps, itching or burning,
treatment depends on their severity. Avoiding yeast infections begins with a balanced diet and proper hygiene. Fungal infections are common in humans and are usually not very serious if they are treated quickly. Taking preventive action helps avoid fungal skin infections as well. It is always best to notify a doctor at the first sign of infection to avoid complications. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
So that's it from us in this edition of In Depth. You can also watch it online on YouTube and Twitter. And don't forget to send your feedback and suggestions about our program. We'll be back same time tomorrow with a comprehensive view on some other subject. Thank you very much for your time.